Listen here, Rocco. Winter sports is over, and now it's time to do some spring sports. Let's try it out.
Favorite sport is?
What is it, Rocco?
Track.
Oh, let's go.
Yeah, let's run.
Let's go have some fun. Okay.
No!
Wow, spring sports are pretty difficult.
Yeah, some might say that, Rocco.
Yeah. Well, are you ready?
Ready for what?
The best Friday ever, Bishop Gorman?
Because BGTV is coming at you in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Bishop Gorman.
I'm Lauren Wallace.
And I'm Chase Stewart.
And this is BGTV. Today is Friday, February 23rd.
Wait, why is February so important?
Because Les Mis starts playing tonight. Here's Isabella with more.
It's an amazing show. It's a poetic show. It's a beautiful show. It follows Jean Valjean and his journey through life and how he learned to become a better man.
Les Mis is a different musical that, like, because it's pretty much an opera, so everybody has to have, like, a good vocal, like, singing point, and they have to all, like, have their own character within their singing voice.
One day more.
Tomorrow you'll be worlds away.
And yet,
come see Les Mis.
Thanks, Isabella.
Speaking of important months for the G, what spring sport is upcoming?
Wait, didn't the golf team just have tryouts?
Yeah, they did. Let's take a look into the girls' golf squad.
Hey, girls, men's golf tryouts were this past Monday and Tuesday at Bears Best. Let's check it out.
Daniel, I'm back for my fourth year of high school golf, and I'm happy to be back on the team.
All right, hello, my name is Gabriel Garcia, and I'm with the Bishop Gorman golf team. You know, I'm excited for this spring. I'm excited for what it holds. I really appreciate the opportunity that Coach Allen has given me, and I'm just excited to get out there and play for my school and all my teammates.
Hi, my name is Marco Mora, and being a returning member of the golf team is really great. I have improved a lot since last year, and I'm excited to play in new tournaments.
Wow, thanks for that information, Zoe. Let's remember to support our girls throughout their season.
That's right. I'm so excited to see what the golf squad brings to the G this year.
Speaking of what next year brings to the G, classes are now available to register for next year.
We have a package to show you a little bit more information about how to register for your classes next year.
What's up, Gales? I'm Nina.
And I'm Omid.
And it's time to start thinking about next year's classes.
Make sure to go to Blackbaud to fill out your course requests. Here's Ms. Broad for more.
Registration for courses began last Monday and will not close until April 5th. It is not on a first-come, first-served basis, so classes will not become full. Take your time and choose your classes wisely, because once a master schedule has been built, we will not make changes to your schedule. Think about what diploma types you're seeking and make sure the classes you choose align with that. We have a few new classes for next year in Theology for Rising Seniors, Women and Faith. We're also adding AP Art History and AP Music Theory, Honors Digital Game Development 2, and Business Entrepreneurship. Refer to the course guide for prerequisites. And last but not least, refer to the Gorman Guide for the registration presentation and checklist for each grade. Come and see your counselor with any questions.
Wow, thank you for all that helpful information. With that, let's pass the ball over to Owen for sports. Owen?
What's up, Gorman? There has been a lot happening with sports here at the G, so let's get right into it. Both the men's and women's basketball team won semis last night. The men's team won with a score of 56-61, and the women's team won with a score 66-44. Both teams competed for state championships. Good luck. We sat down with a few players to learn more about preparation on the road to state. Roll the clip.
What's up, Gorman? Basketball season is almost over, so we sat down with a few players to learn more about their attitude toward the playoffs and state champs.
To continue our success in playoffs, we've been having practices every day after school. We've been watching film on other teams that we're about to play, or old film that we can touch up on to improve our game also.
So we're just playing like a team, and so just staying true to who we are. Just excited to get out there and play for a state championship. We keep moral high by competing in practice every single day and preparing for the state championship.
We're just gonna play hard and play as a team and just keep doing what we've been doing.
We're all excited to play, and I think we just gotta take one game at a time.
Honestly, it's really easy to keep the energy high because we all want the same thing. We've all been working really hard ever since like early summer. So to be able to be in this position now, it's really huge for us, and we haven't been low on energy at all.
You know, we just want to win, so.
This has been Nick Moore reporting for BGTV.
Thanks, Nick. Both the swim and track team had their tryouts this week. Good job to those who made it. In sports outside the G, Shane O'Hanley and Benjamin Vaskov covered the Golden Knights game. Let's check it out.
What's up, Bishop Gorman? My name is Shane O'Hanley, and welcome to Sports Outside the G. It has been quite the chaotic week for the Knights, starting off against Carolina,
where the Knights were without Jack Eichel, William Carrier, or William Carlson. The Knights drew first blood with this goal by Jonathan Marchessault in the first period, but unfortunately weren't able to overcome three unanswered goals by Carolina and ultimately fell with a score of 3-1. After the game, I talked to Nick Haig. Here's what he had to say.
In terms of this game, what do you look to build on for next Tuesday's game against Nashville?
We'll just, you know, we know what makes us a good team, right? So we'll look at it, learn what we have to learn.
Then the Golden Knights traveled to San Jose to face off against the Sharks. The Knights got off to an early lead thanks to goals by Michael Amadio, William Carlson, and newcomer Mason Morelli. And they never looked back, tacking on another goal by Keegan Kolesar in the second period, ultimately pulling away 4-0. And fresh off a game against San Jose, the Knights went right back to the ice and faced off with the Nashville Predators on Tuesday night. They fell behind from the beginning thanks to a goal by Luke Evangelista early in the first period. The Knights gave up two more goals before bringing the score to 4-2. They responded late in the third period with a goal to make it 4-3, but an interesting decision by head coach Bruce Cassidy to pull a goalie with 2 minutes and 58 seconds remaining in the third caused the Predators to ultimately get a final open net goal that led the Predators to a final score and a win of 5-3.
That's all I have for you guys today, Bishop Gorman. I'm Shane O'Hanley reporting for BGTV.
Well, that's all I have for you this week, Bishop Gorman. I'm Owen Wells, and like always, keep it real, BG.
That's all we have for you today, BG. I'm Lauren Wallace.
And I'm Chase Stewart.
And this is your BGTV. BGTV.